Footnote is next, and parental discretion is strongly advised. Last week on Footnote, Bill Flaherty, the young budding producer, had just got done totally finishing his new show Footnote that was to air on WCAT that night. But he found out that the entire show had to be re-edited with only a few scant hours left remaining. Bill was distraught. He thought about it and remembered the show fondly and had a flashback. Bill looked back at the show and thought in his mind, how could they do this to me? How could they do it? How? How could they? How could they do it? This fine piece of video art, unparalleled in video access, and they won't put it on the air. But then, through this dismay, a thought hit him. To get the old videotape he had of him and Josh fooling around with the video camera and put it on as the show. All he had to do was get the videotape. He told the idea and was supported by his friends. However, luck was not with him that day, as disaster struck.
The tape's gone.
Yes, the tape was gone. He was again distraught. He asked for an extension, and he got it. Then he grabbed the 9X business-to-business yellow pages and looked for help. He did this, of course, after he shaved and changed his clothes. So he looked, and 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 he was looking, okay? And then, after looking, and looking, and looking, and looking, he found it. It read, Private Video Investigator, Sherman Leach, Private Eye.
Yeah, I can make an appointment today. Yeah, I'll be down there later on today. Okay. Alright, yeah. Alright, bye.
He only had till that night. Could Bill pull it off?
What's her name? It was a hot and steamy day in Winthrop. It was one of those days where you wish you could just sit in front of an old familiar fan, as it gives you an old familiar breeze. It was one of those days where you'd like to sit in a kiddie pool full of ice cubes and listen to the hiss as they melt against your body. It's one of those days where you wish you could just rip off your skin and stick your body in the refrigerator. Yeah, I've seen a lot through these tired eyes. You've got enough memories to fill a gutted African elephant. And when you've seen as much as I have, you begin to know the good days from the bad days. The nice days from the annoying days. The rotten days from the fantastic days. The days you wish you could just blow out of your memory with dynamite. The days you wish you could just rip out of your skull, hang them on the wall. Yeah, like that time me and Rosie got stuck in the closet together. Our two hot bodies close to each other. I didn't want anything to happen. But she took her own initiative against my will. Her tongue was long, wet, and hot. And explored parts of me I wish it hadn't. I was pushing, thrusting, harder and harder, and Rosie was just moaning and scratching, louder and deeper every second. And then, in one burst of passion, it was over. Ah, Rosie, I hated that dog. Never thought I would break out of that damn closet. That mud room, my good suit with all the scratch marks and the tongue marks and all that shedding. I remember a time where you'd get a good suit for the price of 2 pounds of guacamole. She cost about the same as 4 eggs. She cost about the same as a balsa wood airplane with one of those little propellers on it, which wasn't actually much. Yeah, nowadays, a good suit costs an arm and a leg. But if you're gonna pay that, I guess the suit would be pretty useless. I knew it was gonna be one of those days. One of those days when misfortune looks you up in the book and makes an appointment.
Yeah, I have an appointment.
Come in, Mr. Flaherty.
Hi, Mr. Leach.
That's right, Sherman Leach, private eye. His name, Video Investigations by Gabe. So, have a seat, Mr. Flaherty. Now tell me, what's your problem?
Well, see, I lost this videotape that had stuff that me and my friend did on it, and I need it for my show. See, I have my own cable show. At WCAT, Channel 3.
The channel by the sea?
Yeah.
Continue.
Okay, well, anyway, I need to find the tape by tonight, because if I don't have the tape and I don't put anything on, then I don't have a show anymore.
Ah, I see.
Will you help me find the tape?
Mr. Flaherty, your story isn't a new one. A young law-abiding citizen victimized by slimy, underhanded video thieves. Oh, it makes me sick. Makes me feel as if I just ate a raw jellyfish and it's still moving around inside my stomach. Makes me feel as if I just swallowed a cupful of maggots. It makes me feel as if I just jumped into a pool of Winthrop sludge. Makes me feel as if I just bit into a human brain and chewed on it until it was all mushy and spit it out into a plate only to have it shoved back up my nose through a straw. It makes me feel as...
Are you gonna help me, are you gonna help me find my videotape, or what?
Mr. Flaherty, I live to help people like you.
Great.
Because as long as there's video crime, there's always people like me to stop it.
Great.
You gotta pay me or what? See, this is the most important part of the case, going back to the scene of the crime.
So I've heard.
If there's no clues, then there's usually no case.
Great.
Like that one time in Baltimore, when I only needed one clue to solve the case.
Just one clue?
Yeah, you
wow.
See.
What was it?
I'll tell you. You see, this guy called me up saying he had a broken VCR.
Uh-huh.
When I got there, it seems that he had bashed his friend's head into the console. Because, obviously, they were arguing over what to watch, and the guy just went a little bit nuts. Oh, God, that was one of my best cases.
Good, good. All right, just help me look for the videotape, okay?
Yes, of course.
All right, it's right over here.
All right.
Okay, it's right over here. That's where it was last.
Oh, no.
What?
Oprah Winfrey's on.
What?
Oprah Winfrey. Hate missing that show.
Look, okay, I'll videotape it for you. Just look at
that,
okay?
No, videotape isn't as good as live. It's gonna be a classic show. She's interviewing the Jewish transvestite cannibals.
I don't believe this. This is really great. Listen, look for the tape, please.
But Oprah Winfrey's the sexiest woman alive.
Next to Brick, she is. Now look,
Brick?
I came in here, I hired you to find this tape. You're sitting
so
here, you little
tape?
Dwarfish guy. It was supposed to be some kind
dwarfish?
Of private investigator.
Dwarfish? Oh, gee, you're just
on.
So
you're supposed
tall.
To be some kind of private investigator guy.
My
and
face.
You, well, I'm sorry, I'm like, oh, wait. Just help me find the tape,
oh,
okay?
All right.
Okay, good.
So we're here, right?
Yeah, just was there last.
Yeah. Mr. Flaherty.
Yeah?
I'm sorry, I can't find it.
Wait. What?
That particle of dirt looks mighty suspicious. No, look. This particle of dirt will help me find out who stole your tape. Just by looking at it, I can tell many things about the man.
Like what?
For instance, he's about 6 feet tall, weighed about 167 pounds. He had black, scruffy hair. And he wore dark sunglasses. Oh, wait. Also, his last meal was raw ostrich head.
That's bizarre.
I know. Who would eat ostrich heads raw? Wait, there's only one man who eats ostrich heads raw.
What?
Come on.
Hold it. Wait, hold it. You say you know who stole my tape. Who is it?
There's only one man on earth that could possibly do this.
Who?
It's...
What the...
Bill Flaherty's footnote will return after these messages.
Messages.
Gee, I really hate this show.
Yeah, I know just what you mean. This show really gets on my nerves. It's so stupid. God, it's horrible, too, because we can't do anything about it. We're just stuck here. We're forced to watch this show.
Yeah, boy, I really hate this show.
Yes, I know what you mean. It's like we're stuck here forever. We can't change the channel. We can't walk away. We can't get off the TV. We can't do nothing. We're forced to be here.
Yeah. The show's really stupid.
Yeah. If there was only something we could do about it.
Footnote. Don't like it? Don't watch it.
A message brought to you by Bill Flaherty.
People of Winthrop, there have been many studies that show that watching Bill Flaherty's footnote can be very hazardous to your child's mental state of being. We will now show you two dramatic reproductions. The first is a normal, average American family that has never watched the show Footnote in their entire lives.
Gee, what a lovely house I have.
Honey, I'm home.
Dear.
Honey.
Daddy, we're home.
Hey, Mommy, Mommy, Daddy.
Hi, son, how are you doing?
Oh, Mommy, oh, Daddy, Daddy. Oh, what a happy family.
Now we will show you the twisted, demented reality of watching Bill Flaherty's Footnote.
Jesus,
house is
such a mess.
Hey, I'm home, honey.
You alcoholic bum! Get out of the house!
Shut up! Here come my good for nothing kids.
Show for this. See what can happen if you watch Bill Flaherty's Footnote? Don't watch it. Thank you.
We now return to Bill Flaherty's Footnote.
Okay, yeah, all right. I can see that, yeah. But still, I don't want to die.
Wait.
I just wanted to find my video.
There is one chance. I can wriggle my body to have my gun fall between my knees, then remove one of my shoes. I can let the gun fall between my feet. Then I can shoot the gun with my feet. It'll ricochet off a mailbox, hit a car tire, the car will skid out of control into a fire hydrant. Fire hydrant will break, spurting water everywhere. It'll hit a bird's nest. The egg will fall out of the bird's nest and land at such an angle onto the ground that it won't break. Then a woman carrying groceries will slip on the egg, and a can of Del Monte peach cup will shoot out of the bag, land in someone's window, bounce off their counter, and then land in their microwave. At such an angle, though, that the door will close and will be stuck on the highest setting for 10 seconds, thus causing the can to explode, and the woman's pocketbook will be shot out the window. It'll land on the front lawn, and all its contents will be scattered all over the place, including a compact, which will open up at such an angle that the light from the sun will be reflected off and will shoot into the window and burn my bonds, thus breaking them. Think it'll work? It's our only hope.
Hey, which way to go?
I don't know. Good thing I brought my salt detector.
Which way?
That way.
How do you know?
I can smell it.
Yeah.
Give it up, Saul. Never.
Time a villain has nicked me.
Oh, God.
Ow.
Oh,
come on. Ah.
We'll go get you checked out.
Let's go. Oh, yeah, we'll go. Ow.
Come on. You think these videotape workouts have blood on it?
If there were any more bullets, if there were.
Will you just... Ow.
Doubles as a bandage. Ah, Mr. Flaherty.
Mr. Leach,
How
are
you doing?
Pretty good.
Well, my show's gonna be on now, thanks to you.
My pleasure, it's my job.
Yeah, you did a good job.
But at least Dr. Salt is dead, that hideous menace to the world.
Yeah, he is. And my tape is okay, even though he had all his blood on it, but hey.
Well, those are the breaks.
Mm-hmm.
Although I did get my arm shot and my hat's gone. I'll have to find that.
There'll be other hats out there.
I know. Well, Mr. Flaherty, I hope to do business again with you.
Thanks.
Goodbye.
Take care.
Oh, God! God,
oh.